I'm back! Well, it's been a minute since I posted here on YouTube, actually because I went out of town with the family, we went somewhere where we didn't have internet, it was really nice to unplug, but things do keep happening with this A's Stadium saga, and it's now pulling in other entities, and it's going to continue to be a mess for quite some time. So what was the major news that precipitated this video? Well, I was in line at Disneyland with the family when I caught wind of a situation involving the Oakland A's rejecting the Ballers' plans to play a game in June at the Oakland Coliseum. I'd heard a while ago that they were planning on doing this. They were very excited about doing it. This was not a trap set by the Ballers, but it could not have been a better one if it was for the A's to walk into. It seems like every time they turn, they step on another rake. Oh, A's. So here's what happened. The A's rejected the Ballers' request to play a game in June at the Coliseum. They have the right, as the current lease tenant playing baseball, to have exclusivity on that sport. But what it did was create a firestorm. And more importantly, what it did was it took away from a bunch of people, community groups being invited to go to the game for free, employees that could have earned money working that game, and A's fans having a chance to come together to celebrate Oakland baseball. Now, obviously the A's would feel threatened by another baseball team, a Pioneer League team at that, coming in, packing the Coliseum, and outdrawing a Major League team in their own park. As we know, there will be fan protests. There's already a lot being talked about on that front for the A's this season. So yes, it is a very real threat that a Pioneer League baseball team could outdraw a Major League baseball team in their own ballpark. The A's, of course, couldn't let that happen. So let's talk about some things that have happened since then. First, a letter was co-authored by the vice mayor and a city council member to the A's asking for an explanation on the rejection. And let's talk about why it is very important what happens with the A's and the Coliseum for 2024 and beyond. Why does it matter so much what the A's do? Why does it matter so much if they extend that lease? First and foremost, let's just get to the letter. Vice Mayor Rebecca Kaplan, Councilmember Kevin Jenkins wrote this to the A's and Dave Cavill, asking for an explanation as to why they rejected the Oakland Ballers. Obviously, we all know why they rejected the Oakland Ballers. It's pretty easy to see, but the A's never provided any official explanation other than the rejection. So here is what Kaplan and Jenkins want from the A's. We have been informed of your recent communication to the staff at the Coliseum in which you seek to block a new local team known as the Oakland Ballers from playing a single special event game at the Oakland Coliseum in June of 2024. We believe that the date they selected was one that you, the Athletics, did not request or need. In fact, your 2024 schedule has been published and the date requested did not conflict with your schedule. If you believe this was an error and you plan to use the Coliseum on the specific date requested, please immediately clarify that to us in writing. So keep in mind, there are other events that take place at the Oakland Coliseum. You got things like monster trucks, motocross, concerts, other things do take place there outside of A's baseball. Granted, this is a baseball game and the A's are a baseball team, so obviously they're going to be a little bit more upset about that. But they do not need that day, and so in not letting the Ballers play on that day, it certainly sends a bit of a message. If in fact you were not planning to use the Coliseum on the proposed date, we would seek to clarify why you would have the facility shut down and vacant on a date when we could have an event that generates jobs and revenues. Your email to the Coliseum staff seeking to block this event did not provide any information about what your specific concerns are. It is our understanding that you in fact stand to actually make money on the event, including from food and beverage expenditures. If you are concerned that there would be a cost to you if this event occurs, please clarify that to us in writing, including what the specific cost you believe it would cause. So Vice Mayor Kaplan, Councilmember Jenkins, they make a good point. They want an answer by January 12th because they both serve on the Joint Powers Authority, the Coliseum Board. They want to have an answer in time for their next meeting. It'll be interesting to see what answer, if any, they get from the A's, who haven't been saying a lot lately. I mean, I've been gone. I was out of town. And we still haven't seen any renderings. We still haven't seen any information come out of the A's. It's almost like they've gone underground. It's bizarre. Let's just leave it at that. For the Oakland Ballers, let me just say this. I have spent a good amount of time talking to the co-founders of the Ballers, Paul and Brian. These are two guys that grew up diehard Oakland sports fans. They care so much about Oakland, Oakland baseball fans. This was a thing that they were trying to do to give back. They had given plenty of tickets away already for this thing. They had set up things with community groups, local little leagues. This was a celebration. This was not a trap. This was not a PR play. It sure turned into that because the A's decided to reject their proposal. I mean, they already had this thing figured out, locked up, ready to go when the A's rejected it. So again, I've seen the cynical posts. I've seen the people critical. I understand your criticism, but believe me when I say this. These guys genuinely care about the Coliseum, Oakland baseball, Oakland fans, and just wanted to do something cool for them. That was their goal here. What it turned into? That's mostly on the A's. They chose to handle it the way they did. We'll see what kind of answers we get. So why does it matter though? What is so important? Why is it such a big concern if the A's play here past their lease in 2024? 25, 26, 27, assuming they even have a stadium ready in 28 in Las Vegas. The problem is, and you see it right here in front of your face, it impacts everybody else that wants to do things in the sporting world in Oakland at the Coliseum. If the Ballers can't play there in June, it's an issue because they want to do something fun. Going forward, if the A's extend this lease, what happens to the Oakland Roots? The Oakland Roots are trying to build a stadium on the 9-acre Malibu lot. They're waiting for the Alameda County supervisors to stop dragging their feet and let them get that going. But if they can't get that going, or maybe they don't even need to get that going, because if they leave at the end of 24, the Roots could play at the Coliseum. And this is where it gets really interesting. 30 Roots Soul games at the Oakland Coliseum would actually make more money for the city of Oakland than an entire season of A's baseball. Why? Because the deal the A's have with the city and county, JPA, is actually far more friendly to the A's than any other deal for anyone else coming in. If the Roots come in and play games there, if the Ballers come in and play there, the city gets all the parking revenue. They get food concessions. They get all of these things. The Ballers, the Roots, the people that are playing there would only get a bit of the ticket sales. So the city stands to gain a whole bunch of money from parking and concessions. When the A's play there, the city does not get that same money back, because most of that goes to the A's. As Kaplan noted in that letter, if the Ballers played a game at the Coliseum, the A's would actually make money on it. So yes, the A's sticking around past 24 would be a big wrench in everybody's plans. Not just to develop the Coliseum site, but for teams that want to make it a temporary home. Other events that could happen there. That's why people say if the A's are truly gone, if they want nothing to do with Oakland, if they are done and on their way to Las Vegas or bust, then they need to go. Right? They can't keep holding up the Coliseum past their lease in 2024. 2025 and beyond, that's it. You're out. Unless Major League Baseball and the A's want to step up and make some assurances, make a deal to extend that lease and make it actually worthwhile. If 30 Roots and Soul games is worth more to the city than an entire season of A's baseball, then the A's in Major League Baseball should probably make a better deal if they want to play there past 2025. Otherwise, the city will have no reason to play ball with them. So what has to happen if the A's want to play there past 2025? First and foremost, the A's name and colors need to stay in Oakland. Bottom line, you're going to Vegas, you're not the A's anymore. Go be something else. And also, the A's and Major League Baseball, if they want to play at the Coliseum past 2025, Major League Baseball should guarantee or at least put the city of Oakland near the top of the expansion list. They need some assurances that if somebody like Joe Lacob steps up, wants to pay a franchise fee, they can expand and do it in Oakland. They already have so much work done. Let's not throw it away. You want to stay through 2028? You want sanctuary? Then yes, let's make some assurances that you are going to allow baseball to survive in Oakland past 2025, past 2028, if the Oakland A's ever do end up in Las Vegas. Or pay up. That's about it. But if you're really gone, then you should be gone. Don't stay any longer, because you're just getting in everybody's way at this point. Get something done. You're going to Vegas, good for you. Let's see it. Let's see some proof. Let's see some renderings. Let's stop dragging our feet. Let's see how you're gonna pay for it. The people in Las Vegas deserve better. The people in Oakland deserve better. You can't keep two baseball markets in a lurch, in complete chaos, because you can't figure out your own plans, or because you are too cheap to look anywhere but your own wallet for the funds to get a stadium built. It's time. Put up the money. Get the deal done. Major League Baseball says you've done enough to satisfy their demands to stay on revenue sharing. Prove it. Where's the information? Where? It doesn't exist. At least no one's seen it. No one's heard about it. Let's go. Stop holding up Oakland. Stop holding up progress. Stop dragging people in Vegas along. Let's see some actual work. Let's see something get done. Here, there, anywhere. So that everyone else can get on with their lives. Anyways, I guess I had a lot of pent-up frustration. More videos to come. Don't forget to like and subscribe.